best. And come back at you again with another mukbang. So this time, you already know, last time I did the seafood boil, so this time we're switching it up, and I'm switching it up with something that, if y'all from around my way, y'all already know is banging. It's what is banging. Is it banging? Alright? So, let's just go ahead and introduce what this video is so I can go ahead and eat this because I'm starving. I'm starving like Marvin. I'm starving like I can eat a whole cow. Like, I can eat the cow and a calf. A cow and a calf. So this video is a Q&A. I asked y'all questions on my Instagram. I said, ask me questions for YouTube, y'all. And y'all did. So, I got some questions and I don't know if I'm going to have time to answer everybody. Because, you know, I'm so popular. So, I definitely almost dropped my fork. So I got some sweet tea because I'm a sweet bee. You already know. And then I got some BBQ sauce. And Bae got some strawberry packets, but I think he might have forgot about them, so I'm gonna eat them. No chance. So shmoney. Alright, and then I got, alright, so this is around my way, y'all. This is around my way. Alright, we got some Bojangles. They give us like a little biscuit. They give us like some mac and cheese. Hold on, let me just. They give us some mac and cheese. Some chicken tenders is what I got. A biscuit. So we just gotta go ahead and dive on into this because I'm so hungry, y'all. I got my paper towels right here. I got a little water behind me just in case, you know, I get a little parched. And so, yeah, let's go. Let's get to these questions. So, first question is, what's my favorite season? My favorite season will have to be, so that's like a hard question for me because I have two. My favorite season will have to be summertime because I love heat. I tried to open this and it just like. So it will have to be summertime because I love the heat. I love like when it gets hot and you can wear cute little summer clothes. And I feel like that's when I really can express my fashion the most. But, what's it called? What was I going to say? Oh, but I love Christmas. So it's like, I don't know, because I love Christmas and I love decorations and Christmas lights and Santa Claus, ho, 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 and so I don't know, like, you know, but I probably would go with summertime if I had to. But, all right, next question. What's the hardest part about YouTube? Hardest part about YouTube is probably consistency and editing. Like, I feel like it's very, very hard for me when, you know, you have a real life. Everybody has a real life. So, like, you know, when you deal with real life things, like, it's just hard to be consistent. And, you know, with YouTube, you have to have a lot of personality. You have to bring a lot, you know, so that y'all are interested. And you have to be funny. And you have to do this and a third. And that's hard if you're going through, you know, just a lot of things where you don't feel like being funny. Like, the longest things be like the vlogs because, like, I gotta chop up so much stuff and I'm a rambler, so, like, I'm like, that's cool. Next, any new tattoo ideas? Yeah, okay. My thing about that is, like, I feel like if I say my tattoo ideas, somebody that I know is gonna pop up with that tattoo and I'm gonna be mad as hell because I'm like, why are you trying to be like me? I don't know, I inspired a hoe. I think one of them that I can say is like, because it's so common and I don't care if other people have it, is like this. I want to get a dragon just because I'm so into anime. I'm so into the Japanese dragon. What it represents and what it symbolizes. And I feel like my spirit animal is a wolf, but my second spirit animal would have been a dragon. So that's why. None of your business. I need some ketchup. Babe, can you give me some ketchup? Favorite place to travel. So my favorite place that I've been is Dominican Republic. I had a blast there. It was so much fun. I would go back there any single time. My favorite place that I want to travel to, La Vie en Rose. Oh, thank you, babe. Paris. I'm gonna go to Paris. I'm gonna go to Paris. Oui, some croissant. Croissant. Je m'appelle Jordan. Comment vas-tu?
Okay. What's your long-term goal? Where do you want to be in the next 5 to 10 years?
Ooh, deep question.
I want to be successfully owning one of my businesses. I want one of my businesses to really be thriving. I want to have my music pop. I got something coming for y'all that is very, very hot. And I'm just different. And with me, you know, I'm different. I'm everything. I'm electric. I'm fire. I'm whatever you want me to be. I'm water. I'm an airbender. I can do whatever. So I got some heat coming for y'all. Finished to get my LP in. I got all that stuff going for me. So, you know, it's just a big, big boss move. HBOC moves. You feel me? Dream vacation / destination and why? Kind of just answer that. Dream vacation. Probably be Paris, but since I kind of said it already, I'll give y'all something else. I really do want to go to Bali, Indonesia. I want to go to like Egypt or something. Dubai would be very nice to go to. Why would I want to go there? Because it's very beautiful. It's very like, I love the earth. I love nature. I love animals, and they have a lot of just wildlife, a lot of different trees. I love staring at trees. I'm a tree person. I'm a tree hugger. Stop cutting down the trees. Culture. I love seeing different culture. I love like learning new things about the world. I'm gonna put some ketchup in here. What keeps me motivated?
Oh, good question.
What keeps me motivated? Money. Yeah, I need money. Probably like to try to find like my deepest passions and like just explore the world and like my desire to keep learning. Family, friends, like probably like, yeah, mainly my man, like, you know, because if I get down real bad, you know, he's like, get up soldier, and I'm like, I got captain. Favorite zodiac sign, of course, is Pisces, because I'm a Pisces, and who asked this question, she's a Pisces, so we rock. Yeah, Pisces. As you can see, I don't know if you can see that, but I'm gonna zoom in. Wait, this way. I have Pisces on me. Pisces are amazing. We rock. My second favorite zodiac sign is a Scorpio. I love Scorpios. I love how intense y'all are. I love how loyal y'all are. I love how real y'all are. Love me some Scorpios. My third favorite sign would probably have to be either Cancer or Capricorn. Love both of y'all. Love the earth signs. Something you're looking forward to in the next year. I'm looking forward to continuously dropping my music, continuously, you know, dropping new things, getting into new hobbies that I got for y'all loading. Modeling. Love all of that. Like, I'm coming at you with some fire. What does the day in the life of Jordan look like? Well, during the weekday, I go to work every single day. I'm a slave to society, to America, corporate America. Like, you know, I'll get up, go to Starbucks, grab something to drink. I'm always going to Starbucks. Anybody who knows me knows I love Starbucks. I'm addicted to Starbucks. So yeah, I love them. I think they put a little bit of Coke in their drinks. Either go see my friends and we go party like a rock star. Except for my man, because he's my best friend. What are your best tips for networking? Best tips for networking are to be open, always like be friendly. You never know who knows who. You never know who's in touch with who. And to always just don't be afraid to like speak up if you know how to do something. If you hear that somebody needs something, like, hey, you know, I know so and so, or I know this, I know that. Like, just don't be afraid to put yourself out there. Back yourself up. Like, you know, I used to walk around town and like just write hashtags and put my Instagram out there and like just, I don't know, just do stuff like that. Put your name out there. Be bold. Like, a lot of ways that I do it is I model, and my photographer, he gets me into networking with a lot of people, you know, or, you know, you work a lot of things. I'm also a bartender. I network through that. So it's like, I meet a lot of people. I met other models through bartending. So it's like, you just network.
You just talk, 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 talk. Use your mouth, talk.
Somebody said that thing still standing. I'm not lying. Somebody literally said that thing still thinking. She's hilarious.
And yes, it is.
Oh, she's talking.
Somebody said this might be too personal, but how do you handle hard conversations with your love?
Like with my love life? Like with my man? How do I handle hard conversations?
I guess you have to learn to talk to someone and not at someone. And I think that's what anybody you love in your life.
That's something I struggle with. Like, I think anybody struggle with that. Like, it's hard when you're trying to get your point across not to talk at somebody and not listen to anything that they're saying. But you, in order to learn, you have to receive. And God gave you 2 ears and 1 mouth for a reason. So use them.
And not only that, most of the times relationships aren't 50-50. Sometimes somebody's down and you got to give more, or sometimes you're down and somebody else has to give more. But it's about having that person back and communicating. And when I tell y'all, communication is so key. Like, if you can't communicate, then most of your relationships are going to fail. Because, and I'm speaking from a place where I struggle with a communication, because I'm a cutter offer. I'm just like, I don't want to say nothing to you. That's how I feel. I don't care. Like, I just don't care. I don't care. But like, communication is the mature thing to do. It's the right thing to do. So yeah.
When you were little, what did you want to be when you grew up?
I wanted to be a vet. Then I wanted to be a nurse. I'm still gonna be a nurse. So yeah.
Would you rather eat? If you had to choose, would you rather eat on your best friend or your husband?
What?
I don't know what that question means. I mean, I guess I would rather eat on my husband. Like, eat. Like, eat food. Yeah, I'd rather eat food on him.
Yummy.
Are you done?
What are your hobbies? My hobbies are YouTubing. Hey, y'all. Modeling. Catch me outside. How that? What else do I do? I braid and bask. What else do I do? I'm getting into a little bit of makeup. You know what I'm saying? What else do I do? You know, I can make you a wig or something. Like, I can do pretty much whatever you want me to do. You want me to dance? I can dance. You want me to bartend? I can bartend. What you need me to do? What you want me to do?
Modeling a career or a hobby?
Modeling is definitely not a career for me. It's hobby, but it's a hobby. If I had an opportunity where modeling was paying the bills, then I'd probably make it my career. But right now, that ain't it, and this ain't that. So it's just for fun. And I look good. Ha! How do you know when you need to cut someone off as a friend?
Good question.
How do I know when I need to cut someone off as a friend? When they are draining from your life. When they are causing negativity in your life. When they are doing things that are no longer promoting the friendship, but it's making you question a lot of things. And when you feel like you're being used or anything along those lines, like, you're cut. Don't get me wrong, people make mistakes, but you can tell the difference between a mistake and a snake.
Ooh! Are you gonna start taking cosplay seriously and do a con?
That's a good question. I don't know. I'm a little nervous to do cosplay just because I'm a perfectionist. So it costs a lot of money. It does. To like get everything correct, it costs a lot of money. So I don't know how long I don't know. It'll come, okay? It'll come eventually.
Don't pressure me.
What motivates you? Who is your role model? What motivates me? I want to say bad bitches, money, Viola Davis. She's amazing. She's not my role model, though, but she's amazing. My man, he's amazing. Go him. My mom, she's amazing. Go her. My dad, he's amazing. Go him. Like, it's so many people that motivate me to do and be better. My friends, like, you know, that inspire me. And who is my role model? That's a hard one, because I look at so many people as amazing people, but I don't look at them as like somebody I need to imitate or somebody I really need to like be like. I look at people and be like, oh damn, like, yeah, that's popping, that's it, I'm gonna do something like that. But it ain't never like, you know, like what you do
what you do sways me or like how I'm at. Like, nah, ain't nobody out there. Who is a B word you regret not putting your hands on? Nobody. I don't really have no regrets. Anytime I tell somebody run up, they ain't wanna run up. So don't nobody really want, you know, none of this or that. Don't nobody really want no smoke. No smoke. You number one tip on starting a YouTube. Starting a YouTube, you need to come out with stuff that not everybody has. All those little videos about, you know, what are things that blow up your channel are all cool and stuff. But, like, you really need to have personality. You really need to have flavor. You really need to have some pizzazz. A little bit of sparkle. A little bit of razzle dazzle. Mm-hmm. YouTube is just consistency. So, just try to stay motivated because at the end of the day, your views can only go up. What made me start vlogging? Okay, for real, I like to watch myself, and I think I deserve a TV show, and I think I'm really funny sometimes, not all the time, sometimes, to show y'all who I am, or to even look back at my life and, like, when I'm older and show my kids, like, this was your mother, this is your hot mother, you know what I'm saying, like, you know, I get to look back on my life, and always have videos and memories, like, I really get to look back on life. Like, I'll be 55 and I get to look back to see when I was 20. And it's just like, that's an amazing feeling. What's the next recipe I'm making? It's the last question, y'all. What's the next recipe that I'm making? What do y'all want me to make? Drop that down below in the comments. What do y'all want me to make? I got y'all. I can make y'all some salmon. Some honey glazed salmon, mashed potatoes, and mac and cheese, or I don't know. What y'all want? Mama got it all. Babe, what you want for dinner? That was all the questions for the video. I hope y'all enjoyed it. I hope y'all learned some more stuff about me. And if y'all like this Q&A, ask me questions down below for my next Q&A. Stay tuned for my next video coming up. And don't forget to put a thumbs up, comment, and stay alert to the little notification bell, okay? Okay? All right. I'm going to see y'all later. I'm going to see y'all real soon. So comment down below. All right? All right. Do your thing. Do your, oh, my body look. Yeah. Give it to me like...